Critics say Hong Kong is a city changed beyond recognition. The former British colony was promised certain political freedoms when it was returned to China in 1997. But those freedoms are being eroded. 4 years ago, pro-democracy protests rocked this financial centre. Beijing's response was to introduce a draconian national security law.
Protection of national security is everybody's responsibility.
The government said it would restore stability, but it spread fear across the city. The pro-democracy camp say the law is being used as a weapon to silence anyone who dares to speak out. Today, the majority of the political opposition have either been arrested or are in exile. Hundreds of thousands have left. Those that have stayed no longer know where the red line lies. The BBC has been following the lives of ordinary Hong Kongers at home and abroad affected by the changes.
We have no way to do it. I'm doing it. Because I'm scared. Right?
Ronson Chan is one of the most well-known journalists in Hong Kong. He's a fierce defender of journalists' rights. The BBC has been following his life since the early days of the National Security Law. In December 2021, Stan News, one of Hong Kong's last independent media outlets, was raided by the National Security Police. Senior editors were arrested and detained. The charge, publishing seditious material. Ronson worked there as an editor. On that morning, National Security Police came to Ronson's door.
搜集與案有關的東西,罪名是串謀發布煽動刊物,為什麼直播是不可以用呢?為什麼不可以直播呢?Those
found guilty of violating the national security law could face life in prison. Ronson was taken away for questioning, then released, but his colleagues remain in custody.
我沒說的,我沒說的,我沒說的。As
chairman of the Journalist Association, he has long been seen as a possible target.
Okay. I won't comment anything right now, okay? After a meeting with my colleagues first, okay?
It's been 9 months since we last heard from Ronson.
其實我呢一年半載都係咁樣緊緊張張啊，擔心呢樣擔心嗰樣，唉，困難啦，好困難。即係不過都，即係呢一年半載都係咁噶啦，都係困難。Ronson
was recently arrested after a confrontation with the police while reporting.
就喺呢度，我喺呢个门呢个停车场拍完车，喺呢个八一一呢个啡色门口行过嚟，行到中间佢就话截查，拉咗喺呢度，跟住就话我拒绝合作，跟住拉咗。The
Hong Kong authorities said the national security law would only affect a small number of people, but critics say it's transformed this city into a police state. Ronson suspects that he's still under surveillance.
晚
朝頭早又驚有人上門拍門，警察上門，你話係咪好艱難？又唔係嘅，係咪？即係咁，你跟咪跟咯，睇咪睇咯，係咪？你行得正，企得正，真係冇乜問題嘅。咁但係一個人自己人有私隱噶嘛，有自己生活嘅空間噶嘛，成日都要諗住呢啲問題就好困難咯。
Ronson has unexpectedly been summoned to Mong Kok Police Station. As he arrives, so does his cameraman.
I'll keep this distance.
Plain clothes police look on. After an hour, Ronson emerged.He's charged with obstructing the police. It's technically a minor charge, but he could face prison time. Since the national security law was introduced,Pro-democracy media outlets have been raided and closed. It's had a chilling effect on the press. Ronson's arrest has put his plans to leave Hong Kong at risk. He's been granted a prestigious fellowship at Oxford University for 6 months.
I've told the police officer that I planned to leave in 29th of September and I have to stay in England for half a year.They said that they will record it and told the court, told the magistrates what's going on. So I don't have any idea on that.
More than a week has passed and Ronson has been granted bail. He's allowed to leave Hong Kong. Today is his last day in the city. He's going to see his journalist colleague, Patrick Lam, in Lai Chi Kok Detention Centre before he leaves. He's been detained for nearly 2 years.His trial is yet to begin.
He was under arrest and cannot get bail. I visited him once for every month since the last year's December.
即係所以我係好彩咯，佢哋就幫我哋頂咗咯。即係立場記協咁。好，即係 so far 而家我都仲係冇事，生勾勾坐喺度，啊，即係有自由，可以見到屋企人。即係我都一定唔需要太關擔心我自己。即當然啦，如果真係去一個好 critical 危險翻嚟死梗嘅咁樣啊，拉硬坐硬監，其實我你問我都想，我都翻嚟，即係
Some activists have been arrested trying to leave Hong Kong. There's a fear that Ronson could still be detained at the airport. The media are covering his departure.It's not just journalists that are affected by the new law. In the suburbs across much of the UK, a new Hong Kong diaspora is growing. More than 140,000 Hong Kong residents have moved to the UK since the British government provided a route to citizenship for millions of Hong Kongers.
When I open all these files and we're like, cry the Lord. Although I throw them away, I will just keep these stuff here. Because I will remember how harsh I've experienced at the time when I was in Hong Kong.
Ling is one of scores of teachers who have relocated to the UK. She's writing a letter to a friend who is still in Hong Kong, reflecting on how the last 4 years have had an impact on them all.
不論你係離開香港定係留喺香港啊，或多或少大家都經歷咗 PTSD 嘅，係啊，即係創傷後遺症啦，都嘗試隱藏啦，嘗試拒絕接受啦，都以為自己可以忘記啦，可以撐過啦。當中的痛苦也都只有自己才可以真正了解自己真正面對。在1979年一首很出名的歌叫《抉擇》，今早我就重聽這一首歌，一聽又再一次淚如泉湧，我就更加明白到，也都告訴自己我盡了努力了。
Ling taught liberal studies in a Hong Kong secondary school.But some teachers have been accused by the authorities of radicalizing the youth against the government and mobilizing them to protest. Ling believes it's the teacher's job to promote critical thinking.
I always treat them with as my children. I don't allow them to do something very bad or teach them. I don't allow them to break any rules. But if they really break the rules, I would just ask them whether they knowthe consequences, and then I will respect them.
In 2019, students were at the heart of the pro-democracy protest movement. What started as a fight against greater control from Beijing turned into a call for full democracy and later independence.Frontline protesters engaged in running street battles with the police. They saw themselves as freedom fighters, fighting for the future of Hong Kong. Their mantra, if we burn, they burn with us. Aurora was one of hundreds of thousands of students who took to the streets.Fearing arrest, she fled Hong Kong. She's one of the youngest asylum seekers in the UK. She fled in 2020 when she was just 15 years old.
I call my family twice a month or more. It is harder to communicate with them now because everything changed. We have less common topic. The first year was really difficult for me because I had no friend and no family member in the UK.
Aurora has found a new home in the UK. She's living with foster parents, but fears she may never be able to return to Hong Kong.
When I first came to the UK, everythingchange, the environment change, the language change, so I need time to get used to it. Here is my room, and then this is a quite small room in the UK, but actually in Hong Kong I had a much smaller room than this one. And then I got my everything here, I put everything on this table.And then here is my study desk. I miss my friends so much because in Hong Kong after school they always went to my home and then we chat to each other and then revise together. Sometimes I feel a bit guilty because we have a really different situation right now. But before we did the same thing, we kind of fight for the freedom. We fight for a better Hong Kong. But they are in the prison now, but I can't like live freely. So sometimes I really miss them, but I can't get contact with them. I worry that if I get contact with them, they will be more dangerous.
Ronson has been living in Oxford for the past 4 months. He's taking part in a fellowship at the Reuters Institute at Oxford University and is living in dorms.
So this is my room. Very good. I'm Ronson. This is Al. I have my own bed and also a desk and many places to put my things here, places to put my clothes. Some for storage and some places for me to brush my teeth and wash my face. Very good. So this is my room.
Hello. Ronson's promise to return to Hong Kong to face trial. Under the British government's Route to Citizenship scheme, he has the right to stay in the UK.
Most important thing is I'm a Hong Kong people. Okay, it's not depends on how I like the life in UK, how I can get a peaceful feeling in UK. It's just the reason why I needed to go back and why I needed to stay in Hong Kong and what I can contribute my most to Hong Kong. Every time when I go any church, any cathedral around UK, I may light some candles for the people I missed, and especially the defendant of the Stan News case, my two bosses, the former editors-in-chief of Stan News. And also I pray for several Christians and Catholics in some criminal case in Hong Kong. So this is the Reuters Institute for Studying of Journalism. I spend 3 days a week in here for attending different seminars. So fellows coming around the world, some of them come from the good journalism countries, some of them come from the relatively not very good journalism countries. But we have always share our minds, share our feelings and what we have faced before. By the different exchange of views, I think I've got strength for my feelings that I should stay in Hong Kong to fight for the journalism, fight for the freedom of press.
Ling has been working as a substitute teacher since she arrived in England. She's been keeping a diary.
為師不限於課堂，更超越於課堂。
She's set to start a full-time teaching job in September and is determined to integrate into the UK. Aurora has now settled into life in the UK. She's successfully been granted asylum. She's due to start university next year.
At least now I don't need to worry about my own situation in Hong Kong. I always worried about am I going to get arrested? Maybe I will be arrested, my friend will be arrested. So now I just feel more safe.
On the main road east of the square at 10:23 this morning, there was a sudden and deadly volley from the troops.
On June 4th, 1989, hundreds, possibly thousands, were killed when the Chinese Liberation Army put a bloody end to pro-democracy demonstrations in Beijing. It's June 4th. In Hong Kong, police are out in force. Today marks 34 years since the Tiananmen Square crackdown. Hong Kong was once the only place on Chinese soil that publicly remembered the dead.
It
In recent years, the police threatened to arrest anyone who attempts to mark the day. Some are determined. Flowers for the dead, a political statement, a disturbance to public order. The police continue to search pedestrians. Dozens are taken away for questioning. The police detain anyone in possession of candles or flowers. Ronson Chan is back in Hong Kong. He's covering the anniversary of the Tiananmen Square crackdown. He's still facing charges of obstructing a police officer and must still face trial. A journalist covering the day is detained. It strikes a chord with Ronson.
Press, some journalists were taken away by the police officer. I just can say that we can try our best to survive.
The police continue to stop and search anyone suspected of marking the anniversary. This year, the authorities replaced the visual commemorating the dead with a pro-China carnival. Hong Kong was once a place where the dead of Tiananmen could be remembered. Not anymore.
When I was in UK, I miss Hong Kong too much. I never think about future. I come back, I'm just saying that I miss Hong Kong too much. I love Hong Kong too much. But I still think that I take responsibility for my decision, so I stay here.